great. He kept his word, with a minor delay of 5 minutes. I had found a seat by the window. Through the tall glass panes facing Kaigarten, I saw the little chapel that had once belonged to Nonneseter Convent. Not so long ago, it was revealed that there was a brothel in the adjacent building, or a massage parlour, as such establishments like to call themselves nowadays. Hallvard Hagenes got himself a cup of coffee and a waffle, and sat down across from me. "We didn't quite finish our conversation yesterday," I started. He had put some jam on his waffle from a mini pot. "Didn't we? There's some fuzziness at various points, if I can put it like that." He folded the waffle heart and pushed it bit by bit into his mouth. "Oh, yeah?" he mumbled between two mouthfuls. "Let's begin at the beginning. You probably don't know much about what happened between Tordis Breheim and your uncle in 1957. "Much. Barely the actual circumstances. There was this talk of a death pact, which I mentioned to you yesterday, but otherwise, it wasn't exactly the sort of thing you talked about with small children present, and I was about 2 years old at the time. Later, it was never much more than a vague event in the past, briefly recalled when I met Berit." "All right, let's come to the next point, then. When you left Berit for her sister Bodil." He glared at me. For a moment, he stopped chewing. "I didn't really leave her. It was her who... But the two of you were caught in the act, weren't you? You and Bodil." "Caught in the act? What are you talking about? In Grönaviken? Tell me, who have you been..." "Is this Berit? Grönaviken, late May 1973?